In this video, I'll be showing my process as I create a medium-sized painting from my street photography. My reference will be some shots I took in Italy a few years back. None of these shots are great, but I think that I can make something from them using the gesture in this one. I have in mind something loose and ephemeral, like one of the styles of the illustrator Bernie Fuchs, whose work is worth checking out if you're unfamiliar. I'll use Photoshop to cobble together a reference image for my composition. I want more area around my center of interest, so I'll clone and stretch some fringes and tack on some fragments of other exposures and blocks of color before proportionally cropping the assemblage. I'll try out the image with some small studies to test some color ideas and to make sure the concept is interesting enough to justify a larger canvas. I'll transfer a drawing to the larger panel by projecting a black and white version of my composite. I'll try to only take the minimum number of shapes because I don't want unnecessary detail bogging me down later. Around the center of interest, I'll carefully choose some abstract shapes to act as landmarks. After just a few minutes with the projector on, I'll switch to refining the drawing by eye. The result is not a beautiful drawing, but it will give me the guidelines I need. After fixing the drawing with spray shellac, it's off to the races. I want to cover the panel with some kind of middle tone. The color is only vaguely suggestive, and I'm making no effort to stay between the lines. It's unlikely that any of this layer will show through on the final piece, but it's more intriguing than starting with a flat tone. I can even begin to suggest some of the value changes in a general way. As this layer is going to sit and drive for at least a day, I'm going to pick out a few shapes of light with white paint. I've added some drying medium to this white so that it will set up in about the same time as the background. By the end of the first session, I will have a good suggestion of the subject. My tonal underpainting is now dry, and I can now throw some translucent color over it without much fear of losing my landmark shapes. These washes contain some white and are semi-opaque, which is no problem as long as my underpainting remains visible. My general plan is to have the area around the glass have dominant warm colors, while the rest of the picture inclines towards cool colors. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the background, except that I know that I want the white sleeve to bleed off into this area. Even as I block in shapes, I'm keeping my paint fairly dry and the application broken to allow bits of lower levels to show through. I think of it a little like the effect of pastels. I'll be losing and finding all these shapes repeatedly during the process. As I get further out from the glass, I'll be making my whitish shapes more subdued. I want to reinforce these light shapes in the shirt because I don't want them to get lost by the next session's layers. As this session closes, I have a more saturated version of my underpainting in which I have tried on some local colors. My original drawing is still visible. The waiter's head is well indicated without taking too much attention away from the glass. I definitely don't want this turning into a portrait. Everything's dry, and I'm ready to go again. I want to set up this soft after image for the sleeve. I don't want the sleeve to be highly rendered, and I wouldn't mind implying some motion. I'll also want the head to melt away on the dark side. I'd like the hand to use some color from the glass area and also serve as a bridge into the cooler shirt area. I like this napkin as a different kind of shape, and I'm imagining it as a stabilizing element for the glass. The objects in his right hand are supporting characters, and I don't want to make too much out of them. Likewise, the dark shape of his pants needs only to back up the table shape and the hand. I want to at least experiment with some suggestion of objects in the background. But now I'm back to thinking I'm better off with a simpler background. Maybe greenish? Time for some rendering of the near sleeve. It's white, but not nearly so bright as the highlights in the glass. I should have a nice progression of white shapes leading out of this shirt by session's end. Several days have passed, and I want to apply some transparent glazes to enrich the darker tones. It's my last opportunity to adjust some shapes down in value. In the final touches, I'll give one last hit to light shapes, starting with the brightest spot and working down. Here it is completed, or at least stopped. As is often the case with pieces like this, the perfect finishing point is never clear, because there really isn't one. I hope that helps. Thanks for watching.